Hello and welcome to Wandering Wanda. I'm Ariel and this is Walter. And today we are at Waco.
Waco Mammoth National Monument.
Waco Mammoth National Monument. I don't even know where we're at. We're at a national park. Okay, and here today to do the reading will be Walter.
Oh, yeah. Paleontological site, which sits on the wooded parkland along the Bosque River, represents the nation's only recorded discovery of a nursery herd of Colombian mammoths. Visitors can view in situ fossils, including female mammoths, a bull mammoth, and a camel that lived approximately 67,000 years ago. So, we're going to look at some mammoths.
And get our stamp.
And get our stamp. Yes, we have a place for that.
Yes, we have a place for this. Well, there's our tickets. It's a self-guided tour.
We're going downhill, which means we're going to have to come back uphill.
Yeah, that's a...
She's going to be exhausted later.
I'm already tired. Yesterday was a hard day. Anyway, all right, this is a fairly recent find, as we have found out. Paul Barron and Eddie Bufkin was walking down the river, and then they found a bone sticking out back in 1978. And with the help of Baylor University, they raised money to build the dig shelter and the welcome center and other improvements.
And the owner of the land, Jack Gleason, donated the land to the city of Waco in 1996.
Oh, how nice of him.
And it opened to the public in 2009.
Okay, that was a massive tax break for him.
Oh yeah, absolutely.
All right, let's go to the dig. Size of mammoth. Okay, Walter's gonna go over there.
Don't eat me.
Look at that. Wow. Walter is 5'10". So, give you an idea of how big a mammoth is.
Yes.
And here is the actual dig site.
Look at that.
Do they say what is what?
Yes, there's the male. There's a juvenile, there's the female. They have them labeled.
Oh, they have them labeled. Okay. Camel is over there.
That could have been lunch.
That's the camel. No. There's a saber cat. Oh, and they're still digging over there. That part. Look how big that tusk is. It's nice they kept the actual bones here instead of some replicate. Oh, I'm low on battery. We're low on battery. Sorry.
All right, we're here in Waco. Couldn't come here without seeing the silos. Absolutely ridiculous. There's a line for everything in there. There's like three attractions, the bakery, the furniture thing, and something else. And again, there's a line, and around here it's $10 to park. We're not paying that. So we're going somewhere else to have dinner or lunch. We are having dinner at the Bangkok Royal Authentic Thai Cuisine here in Waco. So we'll see how the food is. Okay, beef with green beans, rice, and Walter is having curry. Staying in Riverview Campground RV, and it's 5 miles away from Waco, Texas. So it is very rural. As you can see, it's just fields and farmland. But it's actually nice because we're away from the freeway, we're away from roads, so it's a very quiet night. And again, 5 miles is about 15 minutes away from city center of Waco. And there's a lot of restaurants. A 15 minute drive is wonderful when you want to move. There are a lot of big trucks that come through here, so this road. And we're another mile that way. So we're away from this road. Anyway, Waco has a lot of good restaurants. There's chain restaurants and there's a lot of small owned restaurants. So we're gonna go to Mexican food tonight.
And tomorrow?
I had to let that big RV through. We made it just fine. I thought I was blocking the road. And I'll show you the RV site hookup.
now. They do have electrical issues. I blew a fuse yesterday, 15 amp fuse, for the overhead lights. And I'm not going to report it. It's electrical issues. Their pedestal is probably has a short in it or a lead short, like the last one over at Stella Mar. So there's a chicken crossing the road. So should we ask why the chicken's crossing the road? We are having dinner at Chewy's. Is that how you pronounce it? It's Mexican food. We are still in Waco and in Tucson. I was using Yelp reviews to find restaurants and it let me down. It was bringing me to the worst Mexican place restaurants. So we are now using the app called Four Squares. And at Four Squares has a rating of 1 through 5.
No, 1 to 10.
1 to 10. It has ratings of 1 to 10. And this place, Chewy's, has a rating of 9 out of 10 stars. So we are now just going to 9+, maybe 7.5 stars on Four Squares. So we're gonna try this out and hopefully it does live up to 9 stars.
And it's very crowded, so it must be good.
Yeah, there's a wait, 15 to 10, 20 minutes, so that's not
okay. These are themed rooms, and this is where all the hubcaps ended up in. They're Waco, Texas. Fajitas for two. It's a lot of food. For dessert, we're having tres leches, and it's absolutely delicious.
This is the best tres leches I've ever had. It's so moist, it hits every sense that when you take a bite. I've never had one this moist or delicious ever.
And what did you think of the fajitas?
The fajitas were excellent. Enjoyed every bite, and it was more than enough food for two people, probably enough for four.
Yes. And the salsa is delicious.
All right, we are space 91. Here's the setup. 50 amps, water, sewer.
Now, their electrical pole is not up to standard. Again, I keep blowing a fuse, so there's something wrong with their
electrical. Oh, leveled concrete pads. They have very good Wi-Fi access. Tower there, tower there. Tower over there. We're not having trouble streaming YouTube, BritBox, Hulu. And there's another one. I forgot the other one. Amazon. Netflix is always a problem. Netflix, they, for some odd reason, their bandwidth is too high.